What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to Mr. Joe's Baseball Show. Did you miss me? Because I missed you. I actually missed a week. I didn't do power rankings for week three because we didn't play that many games, Dinger City. Week three was a little slow. So I'm kind of mashing together weeks three and four into this one super video. But actually, it's going to be a little less involved than I had done last week, unfortunately, since I don't really have the time at the moment. However, I still wanted to bring a video, I still wanted to give my thoughts on how things are looking right now, and week 5, things should be right back to normal. So, without further ado, I'm going to start off with our number 15 spot. It's still Nolan. Nolan didn't play this week, not much to say. Hey Nolan, how you doing? Yeah. In the number 14 spot, we have Billy. Billy's record on the week was 0-4. This is, by the week, I mean weeks 3 and 4. So 0-4, bringing their record to 2-9. Billy's season continues to be about the same as last one. It started off a little strong, in my opinion, but right now it is looking like they're kind of returning to their form where they don't quite have what they need to get the job done. But who knows? You know, things can always change. We'll see. It's a long season. We're not even, I don't know. I think we're like a third of the way through. Something like that. So we got plenty of baseball left to play. So I you know, it's not over for Billy by any means. Coming in at the number 13 spot, we've got Dan. Dan also went 0-4, bringing his record to 2-10. I personally just feel like Dan has a little more potential compared to Billy. If I'm being honest, I think that Dan is a baseball player. I know he's a baseball player. He knows baseball, and I think that really kind of pushes him a little further and makes him a bit of a stronger player. So I would say that Dan is above Billy. However, one player has usurped both of them, and that is Spencer. Spencer had a fantastic week, and now I know you look, you see, 2-9. My cat's making a bunch of noise over here. 2-9, that's a terrible week. Yes, but one of those wins was over me. And, if you watch my videos, you probably know that I generally reside in the top three. So that is a huge win for Spencer. He also had a win over Tommy, which is, you know, his two wins were against pretty good players. I mean, I'm an excellent player. Tommy's not no schlub himself. So Spencer, excellent performance, moves up two spots. He deserves it. Who knows? Maybe he's going to go up one more spot because the person above him is Tommy. And Tommy, as I said, did take a loss to Spencer. He actually lost 5 games in these 2 weeks. Didn't win a single one. So he's in a bit of a slump right now. He's 2-6 in the season. He's lost, I think, 6 in a row, something like that. He's having a tough time. He needs something to get him going because he's not a bad player. He's a great player. Everybody has played Tommy. He's beaten almost everyone in the club. He may have beaten everyone in the club. He's beaten Dennis for sure. So he needs something to get him out of this rut that he's in. I'm not sure what it is, but I would love to see Tommy kind of get his spark back. After Tommy in the number 10 spot, we've got Maddie. And what a fall from grace it has been for Maddie. He was 3-6 during these weeks, brings his record to 8-10. He sits below 500 right now. It's just not the place that you expect the runner-up from season 7 to be. You'd expect him to be right up here in, you know, your top 3 or 4. Because that's where he was last season, and that's where, you know, it feels like he belongs. But I guess the competition's stiff this year, and he's struggling a little bit. So I think what we need to see from Matty is a big week where he comes out and he beats me. He actually did beat me during these weeks, but, you know, he beats Connor. He beats Nick. He beats Teebling. He's got to beat everybody. You know, he's picking up wins. He's got one over me. I think he may have beaten Connor somewhere in the mix. Maybe that was week 2. So he does have the good wins, but he's just struggling overall. He's losing to players who you really wouldn't expect him to lose to. You know, Tyler took a game off of him. I think Jason took a game off of him. And you'd expect someone like Maddie to be just consistently winning these games, not struggling to even get to 500. So I don't think Maddie's lost it, but I do think that he's slumping and he needs to I think he might have a mental block right now where I think he started to do poorly in the beginning of the season, and now he's completely down on himself. You know, I've heard him say, like, oh, I'm tanking. I'm going for a low seed so I can have a playoff run. So who knows? Coming in at the number 9 spot, we've got Tyler. Tyler went 2-1 between these weeks. He didn't play that many games. He's 5-4 in the season. He's he comes every week, but he leaves early because he is student teaching. So he, you know, is a very busy guy. 2-1, went over Maddie. Solid. He had a solid week. Not much to say about Tyler. He's a good player. He has the potential to go higher, but I don't think this season is the one for him because of his, you know, real life stuff that he's got going on. But, you know, he's a great player. He's number nines, I think, where he belongs. I think he won't go much higher. I don't think he'll go much lower. Coming in at number eight is Lionel. Lionel was at number eight last week. You saw a different player below him. You saw Maddie above him, I believe. Lionel had a great week, actually. Great weeks. He went 8-1, and if you remember last time, I said that Lionel, he needed a week to get out of his rut. He had gone, I think, 1-5 during the second week. So this is what he needed. You know, 8-1 brings his record to 12-9 after being at 4-8. So huge, huge, huge week for Lionel, and it's weird to see him down at number 8, but, you know, I think because of that rough start he had, I really need him. Like before I said, if he has another bad week, he's going further down. Well, he had a great week, so now he needs to show that he can consistently have, you know, maybe not 8-1 over the course of 2 weeks, but, you know, if you can keep going, you know, like 6-2 or something like that over like a 2 week span, you know, 3-1 in a week or something, then yeah, he's going to climb. He's going to get to the 6, the 5, the 4 spot, but he just needs to show the consistency. That's all I need. I need consistency from Lionel. If you're watching this, Lionel, be consistent. I don't know. You beat me last time we played. I'm mad at you. Number 7 coming in is Jason. So Jason has told me, if you ever rank me below Lionel again, I'm going to replace all your bed sheets with tinfoil. And you know what, Jason? No tinfoil for me this week. You played great. He went 6-3, which you look at, it's a worse record than Lionel. He has a worse seasonal record than Lionel because he has 2 less wins, same amount of losses. However, he did pick up wins on Lionel, I think at least, well, definitely at least 1, possibly 2. He had a win over Maddie, so he had some good wins. I think he actually beat Nick as well. Don't quote me on that one. Sorry, Nick, if I'm wrong. But Jason has shown that he's kind of getting back to the player that he was in Season 7. He has the potential to be, I think, top 5 or 6 for sure, so he's just kind of pushing for that right now. And I think if he keeps playing like this, Jason's easily in a comfortable spot, top 8 for the playoff push. Now, obviously, playoff push is a long way away, but I think he's got it. So I have faith in Jason. I think he's coming back with a vengeance. Coming up next, number 6, Andrew. So over these 2 weeks, Andrew went 6-7. 13 games is a lot of games to play. He goes to 15-11 on the season. So Jason, I think, is right on Andrew's heels, but the thing that's kind of pushing him down, which is similar to Jason being over Lionel, is that he loses the head-to-head. I think they're very, very close in skill. They can both beat the same players. They're both very good players, but Andrew puts Jason in the dirt every time they play. Now, in the playoffs last year, Jason 2-0'd Andrew, you know, no problem. But when it's a normal season game, I don't know if Jason has beaten Andrew yet this season. He was, like, I think 5-2, like 2-5 against Andrew last season. So Andrew, very, very solid, consistent player, you know. 6-7 is not great, again, but he plays really good players, and he plays a lot of games, so eventually it's going to even out to him, you know, being in a good spot, and I think that number 6 is pretty much where I'll put Andrew for almost the entire rest of the season, barring any crazy breakout or crazy slump. He feels like he kind of has the spot on lockdown, but who knows? Absolutely no one. No one knows. One thing I do know, however, is that number 5 spot is T-Bling. T-Bling went 5-3. I think he only played during week 4. However, you know, 5-3 on the week, he goes up to 13-8. Excellent record on the season so far. He's over 500. A solid week. He had wins over myself. I believe he beat Maddie. He hasn't beaten Nick yet, which is something to keep in mind. But T-Bling, excellent player. Tom is great at the game. It's always a pleasure to play him. Always a pleasure to watch him play. He still struggles, I think, against certain players. But he is dominant when he wins, which is really important. I think as a top player, you really want to crush the people that that are lower than you. I think, you know, anyone like the nines, like we'll say like between Tyler and lower, Maddie's kind of a weird exception. You probably want to crush those players a lot of the time because if you don't, you're I feel like you're not as dominant as you need to be. Now Andrew's a special case because he's inconsistent as ever, but T-Bling, he's solid. He doesn't lose to bad players, in my opinion. So that's a really important thing. If you can only lose to good players, you're a great player. In the number 4 spot, we have Nick. Crit Nick himself. A great performance from Nick. He was in 4th last week. I think he belongs to stay there. I think he belongs there. He's 5-3 over these couple of weeks, improving to 13-8, which, funny enough, was the same exact thing as T-Bling. I just think that Nick has the upper hand on Teebling. He's never lost to him. He plays very well against him. He plays well against everybody. Nick will play solid games against every single player in the club, and he loses close ones. And that's my only criticism of Nick. I think he doesn't have the pop that he needs to kind of, you know, he needs to crush the guys like, you know, like Tyler, like Tommy, Spencer, whoever. I say that as I lost to Spencer, but what I'm saying is, like, he needs, like, the solid wins, because the close games are what gets him, and he loses the close games a lot, and that's, like, the only thing keeping him out of top three. I think he easily gets top three. He just needs that one thing. He needs to kind of clutch out the close games. Now, I'm not saying he doesn't, because, you know, 5-3, he wins more often than he loses. Nick's a great player, but that's the only thing I need from him. I just need to see him push some kids into the dirt. In your number three spot, we've got Connor. Connor went 5-1 during week four, improving to a 9-4 record. His sole loss was to me, myself, and he had a great week. Connor's an excellent player. If you've watched him play, you know how good he is. He has a win over Dennis. He's got wins over pretty much everybody. Hard guy to beat. Sometimes people just play each other well. I play Connor very well, so I usually beat him. I've beaten him a couple times this year. So really, that's the only loss he took. He's a great player. He only goes up from here, I think. You know, he's going to contest me for that number two spot, but as long as I keep beating him, I think I'm going to keep it. And if I didn't spoil it already, you've got me in the number two spot. I went 5-2 across these 2 weeks with a loss to Spencer. And I don't remember. Maddie. Lost to Maddie. So lost to Spencer, lost to Maddie. Spencer's a little bit of a tough loss, but he beat me 2 times during Season 7, and you know what? Y'all know where I ended up after Season 7. You're champion. So I'm not too concerned about it. I'm still having a great time. I'm 12-4 on the season. You know, things are going right for me. Everything's coming up, Mr. Joe. I'm your champ. I'm looking good, and I think that number one spot, that's my destination. That's what I'm going for. I don't have it yet. Dennis is an incredible player. And why don't we bring up Dennis here now? Dennis, 2-0 in the week, 6-2 in the season. He doesn't play much because he's very busy with school, but when he does, he wins. You know, he's a great, consistent player. If you've ever watched Dennis play, you've seen true Mario baseball dominance. I mean, he's a great player. I've only played him once this season, and it was in like a weird stipped game where I played. We played story mode teams, which was a lot of fun. I did end up taking that one. But I'll get my clean game against Dennis soon enough. He is incredibly good at this game. So it's hard to say that you could ever see someone go higher than Dennis. I don't see it happening ever. And you know what? Maybe one day I claim that mantle. Maybe by the end of the season I've become the Dennis Slayer or something. But as of right now, I can't see that happening. Everybody knows Dennis is the best. You hear otherwise, that person is straight up capping. There's no way. But I appreciate it if you think I'm better than Dennis. That's cool, I guess. So those are the power rankings for this week or these past 2 weeks. I will be back next week with the power rankings for just week 5. Don't you worry one bit. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, drop a like, subscribe, leave a comment. Let me know what you think of where I put everybody. I know there hasn't been much movement in this one. You know, you saw a lot of the top six stayed the same. A lot of people stayed in the same spots. But who knows, that could be shaken up at any moment. So let me know what you guys thought. I appreciate you guys for watching. My name is Mr. Joe. This has been my baseball show, and I'll see you next time.